In this video, we will learn how the Fisher Type EZH pressure regulator works through this product animation. The EZH is a pilot-operated regulator, so it consists of a main valve, shown here installed in the flow line, plus a pilot above. Also depicted is a pre-pilot, known as a pilot supply regulator, which provides the pilot with a steady, reduced supply pressure shown in orange. Some important components on the main valve are the orifice, which has a sharp seat for achieving tight shutoff. This component is stationary. The disc, it's a flat rubber component that when pushed downward by the spring into the orifice, it achieves bubble tight shutoff. Last is the diaphragm, which is connected to the disc, moving the disc up and down to throttle the EZH's flow. When a higher pressure is sent to the bottom side of the diaphragm, the disc will be pulled upward, allowing flow to pass downstream. Shown now is the main valve with elevated loading pressure, shown in green, on the bottom side of the diaphragm. You can see how this pressure has pushed the diaphragm upward, which moved the disc away from the orifice. On the pilot, the most important components are the disc, depicted here with a triangle shape, holding back the orange inlet supply pressure, the spring, which can be adjusted to achieve the desired outlet pressure set point, the lower pilot diaphragm, which is watching outlet pressure shown in blue, and lastly, the restrictor, which is a small opening that enables the main valve to close by bleeding this green loading pressure downstream. Starting while the EZH is in a lockup position, meaning at zero flow conditions, let's see what happens when the downstream equipment begins consuming gas. Because the regulator is not meeting the increased flow demand, the blue outlet pressure decreases. The pilot detects this decrease in outlet pressure below its set point. The pilot spring is now exerting more force downward than the outlet pressure is exerting upward, so the pilot's diaphragm and disc move downward. This movement by the pilot allows the higher pilot supply pressure to flood into the loading pressure chamber, increasing the loading pressure high enough that it overcomes the main valve spring. This opens up the main valve, supplying the increased flow demand while holding outlet pressure slightly below set point. Before we go through that motion again, notice the order of events. First, the outlet pressure changed. Second, the pilot responded to the outlet pressure change by repositioning. Third, the loading pressure responded to the pilot repositioning. And fourth, the main valve responded to the loading pressure change. It is the same order of events on every style of pilot-operated regulator, both during opening and closing. The pilot, which is the brains, sees a change in outlet pressure and makes the main valve respond. With that in mind, let's watch the animation again. The outlet pressure is decreasing below set point. The pilot notices and is now sending a pneumatic signal to the main valve that it should open because the downstream demand isn't being satisfied. Next, let's see what happens when the downstream equipment stops consuming gas. First, the downstream pressure increases because the regulator is still open, exceeding the flow demand. The pilot diaphragm senses this increase in pressure above its set point. The upward force from the outlet pressure now exceeds the downward force from the spring, moving the diaphragm and valve plug upward and closed, preventing the orange pilot supply pressure from entering the green loading pressure chamber. Next, the restrictor bleeds the loading pressure downstream. The mainspring now overpowers the reduced loading pressure, closing the main valve and matching the zero downstream demand while holding outlet pressure slightly above set point at the lockup pressure. We hope that you benefited from this explanation on the operation of the Fisher EZH pressure reducing valve. Please like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more videos like this one.